right into the Oval Office now. Right. And this is the, His Excellency the President of the
Dominican
Republic.
No,
Presidente.
Mr. President.
Placer.
What a pleasure.
Siento sumamente honrado conocer el nombre de la magnitud suya, de su estatura.
I feel so very honored to meet a man of your stature.
Aquí siempre he admirado mucho.
I am honored to meet you and very pleased to have you.
Es un honor para mí también y me complace muchísimo tenerlo aquí conmigo.
Gracias, para mí una honra grandísima.
It's an enormous honor for me, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Muchas gracias.
Eso no es un regalo.
We've brought you a gift.
Una prueba de simpatía.
It's just a gesture of our fondness for you. It's a commemorative medal. Of the 500th anniversary of the discovery of America.
La comisión que preside la conmemoración, los actos de las conmemoraciones.
And the 500th year anniversary commission.
Resolvió dar dos medallas de oro.
Decided to give only two gold medals.
Una para el rey de España y otra para el presidente.
One for the King of Spain and the other for the President of the United States.
Well, thank you very much.
Muchísimas gracias.
I'm most pleased to have this.
Es
oro dominicano.
It's Dominican gold.
Yeah. Y es el primer país que se colonizó en América, la primera ciudad que se hizo.
Our country was the first one colonized in America, and our city was the first one founded, Santo Domingo.
Yes. Well, please could come over here and sit down. And,
¿quiere usted sentarse aquí?
Sure.
All right, this way, Mr. President. It's perfect. This way. This way, a little bit more. Look here. General.
President, we have to avoid.
Tenemos que evitar toda conversación oficial durante algunos momentos debido a la presencia de muchos
autores.
A las tres oleadas. La tercera oleada será suya.
Sí. Mucha satisfacción siento de visitar.
I feel so delighted to be able to visit you.
Es satisfecho mi gran anhelo para conocer personalmente.
And it's such a thrill to get to meet you personally, Mr. President.
Una persona que tanto está haciendo por el mundo.
Because you're a person who is doing so much for the world.
La paz de todo el mundo.
For peace for the whole world.
Por la salvación de la juventud.
And to save the young people of the world.
Stephanie, they're starting.
The United States is in the vanguard of the struggle.
La defensa de la reserva moral y física del mundo.
The defense of the moral reserves of the rising generation.
Well, you both kind of denied.
Usted es muy generoso.
Es
un gran honor escuchar lo que usted
me
dice.
La verdad y lo que siento,
creo
que como yo lo siento el mundo entero.
No me voy a
decir. Es una verdad que expreso, no es solamente mis sentimientos, sino el sentimiento de toda la humanidad.
I want you to know that I'm expressing not just my feelings, but those of all mankind.
Well, thank you very
much. Muchísimas gracias. Una oleada terminó y se va. Y ahorita entra.
Second one coming in.
Y a veces empiezan a gritarme preguntas sobre asuntos de actualidad.
Todas partes lo mismo.
It's everywhere. It's the same thing everywhere.
Señor Presidente, todo es tranquilo en la República Dominicana.
Todo está tranquilo en el país.
Is everything calm and peaceful in the Dominican Republic? Yes, everything is calm.
Toda la tranquilidad posible en el mundo de hoy.
As peaceful and tranquil as it can possibly be in today's world.
How about our country, Mr. President?
In which país?
Is our country peaceful and tranquil too?
I would say the situation is normal.
How about the ceasefire talks?
La República Dominicana.
Are you happy with the outcome?
Se refiere a quién?
Who are you asking the question to?
President Reagan.
Oh, well, I only have to say, of course, that we look forward to this and hope it continues, but I still think that just as in some other meetings that have gone on in which I have been involved, I think that we should keep in mind that both parties must be dedicated to the things that are said and agreed to at those meetings.
Sounds like you're suspicious they won't be.
I think there's reason to have caution. They have a past record that indicates that we should be.
Lights, please. Are we going to see General Noriega in the Dominican Republic?
Vamos a ver el general Noriega.
Mr. President, there have been suggestions that the Israelis might attack the new Saudi missile sites. How would the United States feel about that?
These people are more peaceful.
Yes.
Ya veo.
President Reagan, President Reagan, will we ask you some questions about the relations with the Dominican Republic and the United States? Okay. Is there a possibility of getting more help from the United States and the Dominican Republic in terms of the sugar board things like this?
We are, as you know, we've had some problems both ways with the Congress and matters of that kind, but I can assure you that we feel that the relationship we have with the Dominican Republic is of the best, and we treasure it and hope to continue that close relationship.
This way. Thank you very much for that reply, Mr. President.
Sir, we have to go, please.
So I feel very sorry. Vamonos. Esto de vamonos.
I hope our relationship.
Ojalá que nuestra relación siga exactamente.
I think it will always be that way, Mr. President. We have always felt very close to the United States, and we feel very close to you, the President of the United States.
Well, I want you to know I appreciate the kind words that you spoke about me at the Miami conference on the Caribbean in 1986. Hello,
Technical Secretary.
Pleased to see you.
Yes.
Hello.
Hi, Mr. President.
Mr. President, it's great to see you. Good to see you.
Good to see you. Well,
thank you.
President Balaguer and I have exchanged a few words in the other room there while press were in attendance, and after they left, both of us spoke to the relationship that we have in our two countries and how much we want to continue it, and I expressed to him my appreciation for all that has been done by his administration, your government, with regard to the drug problem in the world. How very much we appreciate that. And I know the president must have some things on his agenda that he would like to bring up, and we have a few points here that we'd like to talk about also. But, as a matter of fact, if I could, I would go ahead with one. I'd like to speak about relations of a third country in our neighborhood, Cuba, and the recent events such as the Cuban arms shipments to Noriega in Panama underscore, I think, the continuing Cuban disregard for democratic governments. Cuba's connection to known narcotics traffickers is a matter of great concern. Moves too swiftly with regard to this relation. The ship with Cuba, Castro, hasn't very much to offer. His government is bankrupt and his economy is paralyzed. I just couldn't forbear, in view of the relationship our two countries have, I couldn't resist saying a few words of warning here with regard to that. But the President, as I say, I'm sure you may have some items that you want to bring up, and the floor is yours.
Testing 1, 2.
I talk a lot about the four fundamental freedoms of Roosevelt. That's something I talk about a lot in my own speeches. ¿Quiere usted sentarse? Por supuesto.
Thank you.
I think the president presented you with a gold medal.
Yes, he did, very handsome.
Parece que el presidente le presentó a usted una medalla de oro esta mañana, así es, una medalla muy bella.
Yes.
It commemorates the discovery of the new world.
I told the president that he must be here for an hour. He said, oh, what is this story? This is a commemorance for the president. He said, there are only five in the world, one for the Pope, one for him. The Bishop of Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic. The King of Spain.
King of Spain.
And we said, but this wasn't the progress, but this is not a gift, this is.
A propósito de eso, yo he abogado porque Estados Unidos está incluido en la comisión del centenario, la conmemoración del centenario.
I've been fighting to have the United States included in the events of the 500th anniversary.
Parece lo razonable, porque estamos parte también del mundo americano.
It's just reasonable because the United States is part of the American world, I would say.
Well, whatever it's called, I am most proud to have, that medal.
Sin importar el nombre que se le da a la medalla, estoy sumamente orgulloso de haberla recibido.
Thank you very much. It's a very modest thing, but it's just a symbol of the great admiration we have for you.
Well, thank you very much.
Muchas gracias, presidente.
Earlier today, Mr. President, the president presented me.
Quizás sería conveniente mencionar al presidente Reagan que usted ha solicitado que la sede de la Asamblea de Gobernadores de la Cuba Interamericana de Desarrollo en 1992 sea República Dominicana como motivo del quinto centenario de América también.
I think you might wish to tell the president that the Dominican Republic has requested that the Assembly of Governors of the Inter-American Development Bank hold its annual meeting in 1992, the 500th anniversary of the discovery of America in the Dominican Republic to commemorate that anniversary.
I think that makes sense, that'd be nice.
Sería apenas lo lógico y sería muy placentero.
I'm for more and more international meetings in the Dominican Republic.
Yo estoy muy a favor de que se celebren muchísimas reuniones internacionales en la República Dominicana.
Particularly if I'm one of those who gets a chance to attend.
Especialmente si me mandan a mí.
Thank you, it's very kind of you to say that. This is really our honor because of the fact that our country was the first one to be colonized, and it was from Santo Domingo that people went out to colonize the rest of the New World.
Precisamente, me permite, Presidente, cuando le informamos al presidente Lucinchi de Venezuela,